All right. So what are my thoughts on Kanye West's third album, Graduation? Ladies and gents in Cyberland, coming back to you with another album review. And this time we're on to Kanye West's third album. Graduation. So, late registration did its thing. Got a lot more people involved with Kanye. And then, you know, eventually as that started to die down, came the next album. People were pondering what it was going to be and all these kind of things. And, of course, two songs, I recall, came out kind of around the same time. We had Stronger and we had Can't Tell Me Nothing. So, when I heard Stronger, I was like, really? Okay, this is... Music was cool, but it was just... It just came off kind of weird. I didn't dislike it. I liked it better than Diamonds Are Forever. But I was just like, this is kind of weird. Okay, well, alright, whatever. So... hear that, and I was just like, alright, it's fine. It's not tripping about it. And then I hear Can't Tell Me Nothing, and that's where I was like, why do I get the feeling this is going to be a dark album? I just felt like this was going to be a dark album, going to be a very melancholy, not upbeat kind of song, kind of album. Because the song definitely wasn't upbeat at all. Just in music too, both Stronger and Can't Tell Me Nothing, the music just came out, gave me those vibes. So then, album drops. I don't think I listened to the leak on this one. I think I was just, when it came out, I just listened to it. And I was shocked, actually, when you didn't have Bernie Mac in there. I was like, hey, what happened? You know, hey, you know, but, okay. It just literally started with Good Morning, and I was surprised. That song was different. It's like it, but it was just different. And then, you know, Champion was all right. I don't know if the whole reggae thing to me kind of really worked with it as well as it probably could have, but it was cool. I didn't trip. Stronger was cool. I Wonder, I was like, that's cool. It was experimental, like just different. And then Good Life, you know, had been sampled Michael Jackson's PYT from Thriller, and I was like, okay, this is one of those feel good songs, you know, have a good time kind of thing. You know, it's not all melancholy and dark and stuff. And I Can't Tell Me Nothing. And for the most part, the album to me just came off more like not as soulful. I would say more reflective. I think the album was a lot more reflective than maybe the first two. And I guess that's probably because what Kanye was dealing with being where he's at now status-wise. And I get it, that's fine. It just came off more of a reflective album. Wasn't anything I didn't like. Like, you know, it did take a while for me to get in, but I think Kanye's albums in general have, up until this point, it took me a while to get into them, so, you know, it grew on me, and it was entertaining, and there was memorable. I think the most memorable song, the most standout track was, you know, my favorite track is Flashing Lights, but also I would say Good Life was probably the song that most people can just that's what they want to hear. And then Can't Tell Me Nothing Too. But for me, Flashing Lights was, felt, I guess you could say, something different, per se. And it kind of had a thing of, had something for everybody. It had some sense of direction for people about what they should do with themselves. And then for others, it was kind of like, you know, don't worry about all that, just let's go party. And then another aspect is like, okay, you're an adult, like, you need, you got things you got to do, so let's get up and start working on those things. So it had many elements of perspectives of where you could be at your point in your life, depending on your age and stuff, and what you have going on. My rating for the album is a 9 out of 10 Yes Sirs. I don't think it was better than the first two, but it was still good. It's not a bad step down. I just felt like maybe because there were so many tracks on the first two, I felt like this one didn't have enough. And then the songs that were getting released later, if you bought it from Best Buy or if you bought it from here, I was just like, you know what? I don't agree with that shit. If this is how many songs are supposed to be on the album, give people the fucking album. And I didn't find this out until way after I had bought the album. So I was kind of like, eh, I'm not really cool with that. But whatever, I had a way of acquiring the rest of the stuff. My top five tracks, I would say, is Flashing Lights, The Glory. The Glory, to me, was... it just caught me off guard. When I listened to the album, and when I got to The Glory, I was like, okay, this is going to be like another one of those Through the Wire voice things. And then actually when the song kicked off, I was like, oh shit. Like that caught me by surprise. So I really liked that song. Can't Tell Me Nothing, of course. Stronger and Good Morning. I would put Stronger in here in my top five because Stronger is so different from everything that he had did or had done that I appreciate that he was willing to take a chance to do something like that. Not a fan of Daft Punk. I think they had something to do with this, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, but I appreciate what Kanye was doing with Stronger. Yeah, that's it. So if you like the first two, you might like this one better depending on your musical taste, but it's good nonetheless. That music.
Been shoes and cars, wood floors in the new apartment, coupe tour from the store's departments. You more like love to start shit. I'm more of the trips to Florida, order the hors d'oeuvres, views of the water, straight from a page of your favorite author. And the weather's so breezy, man, why can't life always be this easy? She in the mirror dancing so sleazy. I get a call like, where are you, Yeezy? And try to hit you with the old wapty, till I get flashed by the paparazzi. Damn, these niggas got me. I hate these niggas more than a Nazi.
As I recall, I know you love to show off, but I never thought that you would take it this far.